Hello everyone, welcome to Money Magic. In this video, we will know the complete analysis of HFFC with its real valuation, grey market premium and many more. So stay tuned with us till the last. Let's start by knowing the company. House First Finance Company was founded in 2010 by P.S. Jay Kumar and Jayathirt Rao. Home First Finance Company in India Limited is a technology-driven housing finance company with a clear focus on first-time home buyers in middle and low-income group. Further, HFFC offers loan against property, developing finance loans, and loans for purchasing commercial properties. HFFC has a network of around 70 branches across 60 districts in India. The number of active loans accounts for HFFC in the regions of 37,000. The company works primarily in B2C business model. Now moving on to our next topic, customers. Housing First Finance Company, as we told, it is B2C business. Housing First Finance Company customer base is primarily made up of salaried and self-employed individuals. In financial year 2020, 72.6% of gross loan assets came from salaried individuals, while self-employment customer makes up to 24.6%. The company believes in financial inclusion and expanding the scopes of the banking sectors in India. 35.9% of the gross loan assets in 2020 came from customers who were new to credit. Now, what are the products and services provided by HFFC? As the name suggests, Home First Finance Company primarily focuses on the provision of home loans. This includes both purchasing of ready-made houses and the construction of new houses. 91.5% of gross loan assets in financial year 2020 came from home loans. Apart from that, HFFC also provides other types of loans such as loans against property, loans against purchasing commercial properties, and developer finance loans. These products have been very low contribution in loan books. In financial year 2020, 4.7% of the gross loan came from LAP and 1.1% came from the commercial properties loans and 2.8% came from developer finance loan. Now, who are the promoters of the company? The Housing First Finance Company is promoted by True North Ventures, Ather Limited. The table shows the stakes held by the different promoters and individuals prior to HFFC IPO. Now, moving on to its financial analysis, the HFFC has shown a healthy rate of growth over the years. The total revenue earned by the company increased at an average CAGR of 46.49%. The increase in total assets saw a CAGR of 37%. As of the net profit earned by HFFC, that show a CAGR of 90.49%. It is important to mention the fact that in financial year 2020, HFFC net NPA made up of approximate 0.7% of the total assets under management. However, if the credit assessment quality drop for any reasons, this proportion can increase very fast. Now let's move on to industrial analysis. The Indian housing finance market was sized at around 18.7 lakh crores in 2019. This sector has been experiencing a healthy rate of growth on account of the growth needed to population and increasing penetrations of the credit system. Between 2015 and 2019, this market grew at approximately 20% according to CRISIL estimated. The outstanding home loans are expected to earn around 28.4 lakh crores by 2022. Some of the factors contributing to this growth are increasing in demand of affordable housing, rising population, and government initiatives like Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. In the affordable housing segment, the CAGR between 2015 and 2019 was the region of 5%. However, in this segment, the gross NPAs are higher than that in the normal housing segment. Maharashtra and Gujarat reported the highest demand for affordable housing credit. HFFC has a strong presence in these states. According to DRHF, the company serves about 79% of the market in this area. This puts HFFC in the position to utilize the growing opportunity. The market for affordable housing credit is growing and is expected to grow even more in the future. HFFC is placed quite well in this nice segment and has potential to capitalize the opportunity. Now let's have a peer comparison. Housing First Finance Company operates in the affordable housing finance segment. Notable other players in these segments are Groove Finance, Aspire Home Finance, Other Housing Finance, Awas Finance, Aptus Value Housing Finance. Based on the peers comparison on the above companies, Aspire Housing Finance ranks first in terms of assets growth rate and disturbance growth. However, in terms of operation parameters, Home First lives in front of its peers. Based on the parameters of disturbance per branch and disturbance per employment, Home First was top of the group. Overall, we can conclude that Aspire Aadhar and Home First show a healthy financial apartments parameters and assets growth rate over the year. Now moving to our next section, the strength. Among the strength, Home First Finance Company has a couple of competitive edge, which set it apart from its peer. Its market share is very high in specific regions like Gujarat and Maharashtra. Apart from that, Home First exposed to risk in lower than that of its peer. This is because most of its clients have a stable source of income. This reduces the possibility of loans turning into NPA. Now after the strength, let's see the weakness of this company. Whenever we talk about things like house grading, loan, long-term exposure to risk is implemented. If you top that off with the fact that Home First Family service middle and low income groups, the possibility of risk becomes explicit. Loans can be turned into NPA in the blink of an eye. This put Home First in the volatile and precarious position. The proportions of NPA for the company has been grown from 0.5% in 2018, it grew to 0.7% in 2019. This parameter is worrisome. There is also the fact that the company business is not well spread out across the country. It is more concentrated in places like Maharashtra and Gujarat. This lack of the diversification poses a risk for HFFC. Now let's see the valuation of the company. For calculating the valuation of company, we use the simple and most famous method that is given by Benjamin Graham. Now let's calculate the valuation of the company. As we see in the financial year 2020, the profit was 79.3 crores. And if we assume the growth rate to 10%, the valuation of company comes out to be 2260.05 crores. And we minus the margin of safety, we get 2034.04 crores. As from the IPO pricement, the market capitalization of the company is around 4040.4 crores. If we assume the growth rate to be 15%, then also its valuation comes out to be 2747 crores. And if we assume the growth rate to 20%, the valuation comes out to be 3461 crores. But the growth rate of 15 to 20%, which is very difficult to sustain, and in that growth rate also, the valuation of company comes out to be expensive. Now let's see some other valuation for the company. As from the table, we can see that the price to book value of HFFC is much higher from their competitor, and price to earning ratio is above the average, whereas the return on equity is below the average, with 8.49% only. The one good thing about it is the NPS. The net NPS is only 0.8%, which is very good as compared to their peers. And if you are buying this company for long-term prospect, you should consider that this stock is coming in overvaluation zone. And to get listening gains, the valuation does not depend much more. The most important parameter which depends for listening gain is grey market price, which will be discussed in next slide. Now let's see the objective of the IPO. The objective of the IPO is to augment company capital base to meet future capital requirement and to meet some general prospects. And now let's see the IPO details. IPO is starting from 21st January to 25th January. The issue size is of 1153.70 crores and fresh issue will be 265 crores. The face value was kept 2 rupees per share. The IPO price band is 517 to 518 per equity shares and market lot of 28 shares. The IPO will be allotted on 29th January and the listing of IPO will be done on 3rd February. The maximum lot a retail investor can buy is 13. Promoters are decreasing their stakes from 52.85% to 33.70% through an offer for sale of 888.72 crores. And the most important parameter is grey market price. Currently, the grey market price of this IPO is trading at 90 to 100 rupees. Thank you for this video and stay tuned with us.